Yeah, something's got it.
Give it a wind. Give it a wind. All that weight's come off. Give it a wind. Is it still light?
Yep.
All the weight has come off of our deep bait, which could mean there's a swordfish that's got our bait and it's making its way to the surface.
Keep the weight there now.
Yep. But look at that rod tip. Boom, boom, boom.
I've headed out on my Staby craft with a couple of mates and we're exploring the outer reaches of the Hauraki Gulf around 100 miles from the downtown Auckland. We've been dropping baits down on deep reefs and we've caught snapper, kingfish and a barracuda that became bait to catch some bluenose out of over 500 metres of water.
We've got our bluenose, boys!
And while setting a bait for a swordfish, we caught a mysterious deep sea monster.
Holy smokes, a big oil fish, I think. An oil fish, never caught one, that's a first for the show. Gnarly!
It's been a full-on day, but we're still in pursuit of the ultimate catch, a broadbill swordfish.
Well, now that nighttime has descended, and given we're so far from home, we've decided we're gonna stay out all night. And if we're staying out, we might as well be fishing, so I'm gonna put our squid on, and those swordfish coming up from the depths to feed on the surface, might just spot that and take a fancy to it.
That was a bite, I'm pretty sure, eh?
Well,
that's been smacked well and truly. No teeth marks. You'd have to say a swordfish.
So we might just chuck in a couple more baits. Okay, we're bit.
Something is messing with this bait.
Flick the spotties on, Pete. Okay, we're tight and I can see the lights. I can see the fish. Oh, it's a shark, I think. What is it?
Yeah.
It's a shark. Oh, it wrecked my squid bait. Okay, let's find a new place to put out our baits, eh?
We've got another bait going over.
She's loading up. There he is.
What is it?
It's a shark.
Marco.
Oi.
Boom.
See you later, Mr. Marco.
Razor sharp teeth, look at that pain. Good result, really. I didn't fancy messing with him in the middle of the night. Down goes another bait.
We've had a rude awakening, and that as we're sleeping, we've had a bait set out, and that bait has been eaten by something.
It's heavy, and it's big, and it's eaten the whole skippy.
It is a shark.
Uh-oh.
Now, with these sharks like this, and I have had it before, they spin when they're in trouble and they can roll themselves up the line just like he's doing now. Jeez, just like he's doing now, right on cue. They roll up the line and they can quickly end up in your face or in the boat.
That's it.
There you go, well.
Wait.
Spitting through the line.
Oh, yeah.
And he's away.
Crikey.
Nice way to wake up, nice alarm clock, boys.
Crikey dicks.
We might have to put the billy on. Have a cuppa. Think about what we're going to do with our day. Step one, wake up.
Yeah.
There you go, mate. Hot cuppa in the morning. Out of our custom made cappuccino machine, mate. Okay, and ready? Sleep deprivation.
With some breakfast in our bellies, we decided to once again drop a bait in over 500 metres of water. And just like yesterday, the bite was instant.
Okay, I'm going to have to tighten up and see what happens.
Got it, whatever it is, I think.
Oh, yeah.
Back to work again. I tell you what, it makes every fish last when every bite means a 600 metre wind. You get to savour the fight. Then we might have to go to the old 80 wide next time. Just because if we do hook a swordfish, we can find one out here. Just with my line capacity, I might have to have a little bit of a rethink. Whereas we're holding close to 1,000 metres on our Tiger 80s. Well, you wouldn't believe it's middle of winter, would you, at the moment? Here's our top shot. What have we got this time?
It's a blue dog.
Oh, blue dog. Another one. Well, we'll be eating very, very well. It's a bigger one.
It is bigger.
Nice. Oh, well, we've taken care of your blue nose you wanted, Pete.
Thanks, bro.
Right, now let's, I think maybe go a bit deeper, get away from these fellas, and maybe go to some whole tuna baits.
That was stellar, eh? Powered it up.
Powered it up, mate. Smoked them.
Yeah, something's got it.
Give it a wind. Give it a wind. All that weight's come off. Give it a wind. Is it still light?
Yep.
All the weight has come off of our deep bait, which could mean there's a swordfish that's got our bait and it's making its way to the surface.
Take the weight down now.
Yep, spill it and watch it. Boom.
Well, I hope you're enjoying this classic episode. But if you'd like to see our latest content, action, tips, and how-to videos, you can get it all on the Ultimate Fishing app, available now at the App Store, Google Play, or by visiting ultimatefishing.tv.
The place where we attach our mono, which is our breakaway.
Now, it's not only advancements in trailer boats and outboard technology that gives us the confidence to come out here, but without good electronics, I mean, we just wouldn't know where the heck to start. But my Freno Navnet, it tells me exactly where all the seamounts and all the structure is. And of course, look at this. I mean, I've got a crystal clear picture at almost 600 meters down below me. And at the moment, I'm just trying to sound out this area, look for any signs of life, bait fish, anything like that, where we can drop a bait, and there might just be a swordfish lurking around down there. Looking at that bait that Grommet's holding there, and the fact that we're in 600 metres of water means I've still got a swordfish itch to scratch. A daytime swordfish. Okay, Grom, when you're ready, mate.
There you go.
She's going.
Was that you, Pete? Yeah, I saw something there.
Bit of weight there,
mate.
Might
want to
fit that.
Yep.
Something's there.
Something's there? Yeah.
Oh, yeah, no, there's a little load there.
Probably a gemfish, eh, or a spiny
something. Well, we don't know. We're well off the bottom, eh?
The rod will go loose soon, and you have a big belly there.
There's something going on there, I think. It just feels normal at the moment.
Might have been just a big swell pulling a little bit of string, eh?
Hmm. Oh, no, something just...
Yeah, something's got it.
Give it a wind. Give it a wind. All that weight's come off. Give it a wind. Is it still light?
Yep, loose.
Yes, it's loose. That's what we want. Okay, all the weight has come off of our deep bait, which could mean there's a swordfish that's got our bait and it's making its way to the surface. If that happens and we get a swordfish jumping during daylight, that is very, very special. Weight coming on? Yeah, okay. Give it a wind there, mate. Something's on its way up. Keep it tight from now on, mate. Can you give me weight back?
Not yet. Slow.
Might be a big belly in that line.
Keep going, mate.
I'm starting to get excited. Keep going then, brother. Keep going. Keep going, mate.
Take the
weight
down now.
Yep, because we've got a fishy on. Keep winding. Yeah, keep working it, mate. Right. Inside that harness.
I'm glad we got all this fitted up.
Oh, I'm hoping, mate, it's a sword. Let's see.
It ain't a snapper. If it is, well, it could be, you know. Auckland's known for its snapper fishing.
Be a goodie.
I mean, if by scale of depth, you know, most people catch their snappers in 30 metres of water, we're in 600, that's 20 times deeper. It could be like, say, a 20 pound, it could be a 400 pound snapper. Just quick little bit of maths there. Oh, go, wind. Keep tight, mate, keep tight, don't. A bit of a J hook, you've got to stay extra tight, okay? Go, jack it off. Keep winding, mate. Stay tight. Keep everything nice and tight. I have seen these fights go on as long as 16 hours and 40 minutes with swordfish. They are epic. But we don't even know it's a swordfish. If it is a shark, you think it'll be a thresher. I think too deep for a Marco. Could be just a school shark or something. Scabby old school shark, something. Spiky dog.
A little bit of a shake there.
Yeah.
Get a bit of a head shake.
Felt something, mate.
Now, I have had it before. Very
shake there.
Very early in the fight with swordfish, I have had them come to the surface and go nuts. In fact, I've even had them come straight to the boat after hooking them and attack the boat. Hence that lump on my hand, broken from a swordfish, 300 kilo one that came straight to the boat. They're psychos sometimes. Other times, they just go deep and hard. Oh, he's just woken up.
It's no spiny dog.
No, that's stuck to the line. You haven't got much weight from line drag in the water now, Pete, so you're going to have to keep plenty of weight on when it's short. Yeah, my boys.
Yeah. Come to me.
All right, do you want me to drive forward on him?
Drive forward on him, mate.
Okay.
Okay, he's turned. A bit of a head shake there.
Okay, I don't want him to, because they can change direction real quick. I don't want him to charge away under the boat because he's still real green. Just.
Yeah, oh.
Oh, yes, there's some weight there, boy.
Oh, yeah. There he goes.
Oh, yeah. There he goes. Look at that reel going for the first time. That's cranking out. That was bit 500 metres below us, 550 metres below us. The fish has come all the way to the surface, and now he wants to go home.
Yes.
Although we might have something to say about that. Yeah, look at the load on that boy.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Okay, just keep everything tight,
there,
mate.
Taking his head there. Oh, yeah.
So all that time with hardly any weight, eh?
Yeah. And hopefully he's eating that puppy good.
He's off now, mate.
This is on. I'm thirsty, I'm not even winding.
Speaking of which, would you give me one of those drinks, bro?
What about a chamomile tea, uncle? Listen to that. Listen to that. Use the drag,
load
mate.
On there, mate.
Use the drag if you can, mate. Go up and over the button, don't be shy. Oh, listen to that. Now, just be aware, if there's any real hard head shakes, it's either going to speed up and run, or he's going to come back at you. It's generally what happens. Okay, I'm just backing up to try and take some of the load off that line, that cements. Oh, yeah! Woohoo! Just about to drag you in, Petey.
Really?
Yeah!
Yeah, baby!
Okay, get ready, and wind. Just going to idle forward, try and change the angle up on this fish. What we want is we want him to jump here and fill up the frame on our contour camera right there. Right, we'll jump right through the frame.
I'll ask you for much.
That's swordfish jump cam right there. That jumps right through here. Grab him by the bill, smack him on the bum as he goes past.
Whack a tagging.
Yeah, whack a tagging. And put a line red.
Trust your knots right up the sunset, brother?
Do I trust my knots? Is that one of the ones that had a loop on it, or is that? Oh no, that's old Lucky. That's old Lucky. No, I've just retitled the knots on that one.
Sweet.
Yeah, I trust him, mate. That rod and reel has caught about 20 or 30 swords. That's one of the ones, the old ones from prime time. Once you've got that rigged up, mate, you can just either hook it on the ladder or even hook it around the
there.
Yeah, just somewhere where it's out of the road, and you can grab it and get it to the side if we need it. But unless it's a real donkey, we'll probably tag it. But it's there if we need it. Oh, sorry, mate, you're a crook.
Oh yeah, I'm alright, I'm just
excited.
Oh, just get it out of the way, eh?
That's what swordfish does to people.
And you try and bring up, go forward. Yeah. Oh, must be getting old.
I've seen it happen before. I've seen grown men broken by these fish. Whimpering. Oh yeah, mate. That fish will be down there. I mean, just big head shakes. Spill it and rot it. Boom, boom, boom. There's no mistaking those big head shakes.
Here it comes.
Oh yeah. Shake, baby, shake.
I need more head shakes.
Good impression of a swordfish there, Pete. Oh yeah, listen to that. It's got some serious weight on it there, boy. Okay, we've ruled out spiky dogfish, and we've ruled out snapper. Okay, I might just drive from inside until this fish is a bit closer, eh?
Getting a bit cold out here for you, mate.
Yeah.
There's a bit of a nip in the air. Yeah. Matt's going to go into his lazy boy and pull up his knee blanket.
Yeah, that's it, mate. In the front. That's it, you talk it up, mate. I tell you what, when you're whimpering in 3 hours' time, you remember that. He can't be that far away, eh? He's not. I reckon he's less than 40 or 50 metres away from us. Come on, show yourself.
So we bunk clear up there, mate, for later after I've done this. I might need a little nap.
What surprise you haven't had one already, Pete?
Oh, mate, come on.
These swordfish, they just seem, you can fight them to a certain level, at like now, and he just puts the handbrake on Pete, and down he goes again. And I've seen stalemates where the fish has not taken more than 10 metres of line, and we have not gained more than 10 metres of line, that have gone on for hours. He just sits in that zone. And they're such a big broad fish, and they've got that big broad bill, hence the name broad bill, and it acts like a big paravane. And of course, we're pulling from behind that, and that big flat angled bill and that big flat head just digs on down and planes down.
Like a big Rapala, right?
Yep. Big Rapala. Good analogy, Pete. That's why we bring you along on these things.
Technical talk.
Oh, big head shake. Oh, there's colour down there.
Is there?
Yep, there's colour down there, I think. There's colour, we can see the fish.
There it is, there's the double. There he is, there's the fish.
It's a sword. Sword, I can see him.
Keep going, mate, keep going.
Yeah, I'm still going, I'm still going. Still going, mate. There he is, broadbill swordfish right there. We've got the leader. Okay, just bring him towards me, Pete. It's a nice one, too. It's a blooming nice one. Keep winding, Pete. Keep winding, Pete. Keep winding. Whoa. Keep winding, Pete. Keep winding.
All right, mate?
Yeah, I'm all right, mate. Hang on, he's coming out of the boat. I've got a wrap.
You got a wrap?
Yeah. We've got a swordfish under our boat, guys. Tag him, mate.
Tag him.
Yeah. And he's got tagging him. It's a fatty too, boy.
That's
a nice fatty here. Yeah. You think it's sucking? They reckon they suck him back in the way. Watch that sword. Be careful of that sword, mate. As soon as I pull his head around,
yeah, mate.
You have to watch that sword. Where's he hooked? He's hooked in the corner of the mouth. He should be okay. Okay, there we go, swordfish boys! Hariki Gulf swordfish. Well, the outer Hariki Gulf.
That's a nice one there.
All the same, nice trailer boat fishing. We drove out here. It's a nice fatty, eh?
Yes, good one.
Oh, look at that long sword. Now, he's got his stomach. He's hooked in the corner of the mouth, so he'll be fine. But you see, what a lot of these fish do, marlin, swordfish, and even tuna, they'll turn their stomach inside out. And it's not just a trait that they do when they're hooked. Naturally, when they suck down too many fish or spiny fish, they will regurgitate them. And we have it on good authority that they suck it back in. A lot of fish get taken because they go, people say, oh no, their guts is hanging out. Sharks do it also. Great white sharks are known for doing it. So what do you reckon? Just make sure there's no blood coming out of his gills. Watch that sword though, mate. They can rear up and they will have a crack. Look at the length of that bill. Look at that great big sword. It's a nice, big, long, clean sword. That big eye.
What a flash, guys.
It's a fatty, eh?
Yeah, mate. It's a good one.
Well done, Pete.
Well done. Not bad for a few learners.
Yeah.
Well done, bro. Well done, man. Just look at that magnificent sword. Just be careful of it. They use it as a weapon. Oh, look out. See, that's what they can do. That's what they can do. Watch that, mate.
He's right there a little bit heavier than that 127, eh?
Okay, yeah, I was going to say about 130, 140. Yeah. They do weigh heavy. Look at the bulk right through the caudal keel on that thing. Okay, well, we're just going to do our best. We're going to watch he doesn't whack anyone with a sword, because that would ruin your whole day, getting whacked with a sword from a swordfish.
Yeah, now what do you want to do, mate?
Okay, you see if you can grab the bill and I'll get the help. Just be careful, they don't like their bill being touched too much. You tell me if you're going to let go, Pete. Tell me if you're going to let go, mate. Hook's out.
Hook's out.
Beautiful. Okay, I'm going to go neutral. He'll go down there and he'll suck that hook up. Get the fish, Blair.
Ready?
Yep, down, mate. Pull him towards the camera. Oh, he had a thrash, dude. Keep an eye on him. We'll keep an eye on him. We'll stay with him. Oh, he might be. Grab that fixed head gaff on the other side, Pete, under the combing. Come on, you can go, buddy. You can go. You can go. Oh, no, I'm going to have to watch that sword. I'm just going to push down.
Is he gone?
Go, no, I'm trying to push him down, but... Oh, come on. You can go, buddy. You can go, buddy. Of course, if he can't go, we're not going to let him go to waste, and we're going to eat him because they are fantastic eating.
And if we don't, the sharks will.
Yeah, if we don't eat them, these things are a favourite of Marco sharks.
Okay, go forward.
Yep. Watch him, mate. Watch him, watch him, watch him. Oh. Oh, he's away, is he? Come on, you can do it, buddy. You can do it, you can do it, you can do it. Yeah, I'm saving him. Nah, we're going to have to take him, guys. Yeah, we're gonna have to take him. Yep. All the excitement's a bit much for Grom. Okay, we'll just get this. We'll just get the swordfish in there, Nate. Just watch that gap, Pete. We don't want to be... Damn, I missed you for that. Awesome. Tell you what, there's a few snappers in that lot.
Roger.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, what a beautiful fat fish.
Oh, that's a fatty. That's a nice one, boys. Well done, Pete.
Yeah.
There you go. Bit of daytime sword fishing.
Right. We hope you enjoyed this classic episode. But if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, You can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.